It must be a proud moment for all the graduating students and families here today. I'm sure the feeling is also mutual in the faculty and staff who worked hard to see yet another successful graduation day. It is naturally also a proud moment for me personally, as I am in fact taking over as a chairman for the first time of this very, very prestigious Institute of Excellence. I'm honored to be given this opportunity and to be following in the illustrious footsteps of my predecessor, Adi Godrej. On behalf of the board, the ISB community, and on my own personal behalf, I thank Adi Godrej again for his outstanding leadership of the executive board and his enormous contribution to the school since inception. I've had the pleasure of working with Adi on this board for many, many years, and all I can tell you is we wouldn't be here if it wasn't for his commitment and his sense of purpose for the school. I'm also very delighted that he will continue to serve on the board and stay engaged with the school, so he's not leaving us, and I'm particularly happy about that. We're also very fortunate, of course, to have with us today a Padma Bhushan, Dr. Radhakrishnan, a renowned space scientist. And you heard Dean Srivastava introduce him. And all I can say is that in my 40 years in business, I've always said, business is nothing but common sense, and it's not rocket science. I'm sorry, I can't say the same thing about what Dr. Radhakrishnan's business is. It's all about rocket science, and it's all about doing things that we can only dream of, and I'm looking forward to personally listening to him describe his own journey and lessons in life. I have been an admirer of this school's progress ever since its inception. My congratulations to the ISB community for their continuous effort to make this institution to where it stands today. You heard some fantastic rankings and numbers which Dean Srivastava spoke about. The fact that you are the youngest business school to be consistently ranked amongst the top 40 business programs in the world. And in fact, in the latest rankings, you're number 28. But what's more important, you're number one in India. That's fantastic. As a proud father of two lovely daughters, I'm equally and probably even more proud of the fact that in the FT inaugural top 50 AMBA rankings amongst women, this is the only business school that featured in the ranking from India. So fantastic. Well done. In less than two decades of existence, ISB stands as a great example of how to impart and continuously improve delivery of quality education, how to scale up while maintaining high quality standards, and importantly, to convey to the world that all this is possible because we are an autonomous and independent management institution. I'm particularly enthused by the recent decision of the HRD Ministry to grant autonomy to a good number of educational institutions in the country. Collectively, this will help to transform the country's capability to build intellectual capital and promote critical thinking across disciplines. The future is going to be defined not by who has the economic capital in the future, but whoever is going to have the intellectual capital. And many of you here are actually part of that great intellectual capital that India has to build. I also want to talk a little bit about what I feel very passionately. We do live in a time of paradoxes. On the one hand, technology is connecting millions across the globe in real time, making it possible to collaborate and innovate. On the other hand, we are seeing increasing challenges to globalization in the form of protectionism and tendencies towards insulating economies. The revolution started with the advent of the internet, when business models underwent a massive change. And this happened while I was in my career. The internet enabled outsourcing and globally integrated supply chains that significantly reduced costs and accelerated growth. This meant productivity and ease of doing business for the developed world, but it also brought millions of people in the developing world into the booming middle class. However, further advancement of technology, something you're all familiar with, artificial intelligence, robotics, is now challenging the very models that were created at the turn of the last century. We are now entering a phase where further advancement of technology has the potential of totally restructuring not just global models, but the nature of work in society. At the same time, societies are not only raising concerns about technology-driven unemployment, but also widening income gaps between the rich and the poor, and the depleting natural resources across the planet. These are big issues that are challenging society, businesses, and individuals in a very, very profound way. In this fast-changing and increasingly complex global environment, companies will have to reimagine not only their business models in terms of what they do and how they do it, but more fundamentally, their role in society. In order to reimagine this future, business needs a new kind of leadership. It needs leaders who can, of course, grow businesses and create shareholder value, but are also conscious of their broader responsibilities of serving the needs of multiple stakeholders and, importantly, very importantly, the communities in which they operate. We need leadership that is visionary, but above all, purpose-driven and values-led. I passionately believe that as graduates of ISB, you are well prepared to take on this changing leadership role. The school has prepared you with all the hardware and the software to be the change that India, the world, and society at large needs from the next generation of business leaders. I congratulate all the graduating students, your families, and wish you all the very best in your careers.